Do you want to report on how many times people click the phone number on your website, but you're not sure how to set it up in Google Analytics 4? Well, you're in the right place. We're going to walk through how to quickly and easily track clicks on your phone number into GA4. Tracking clicks on your business phone number lets you understand how many leads your website is creating. And once you're tracking phone call clicks into GA4, you can use this to configure conversions and even track the number of phone number clicks in your linked Google Ads account. To track clicks on our phone number, we're going to use Google Tag Manager. Let's get started. I've opened my GTM container, and the first thing we need to check is if a GA4 configuration tag has already been set up. To do this, let's navigate to Tags. Looking in the Type column, we can see a GA4 configuration tag has already been created. This tag is used to send page views and other automatic events to GA4. If you're getting started with GTM for the first time, or you don't have a GA4 configuration tag, then you'll need to create one. I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial in the description below this video that will teach you how to set up and use GTM. Since we already have a GA4 configuration tag, we can continue. The next thing we need to do is head to our website. I'm going to open my demo site. And let's navigate to the contact page. At the top of the page, we can see there is a phone number and it's clickable. We're going to track clicks on this phone number into GA4. To do this, we need to identify how we can configure GTM to only track clicks on the phone number and not other links, like the link to Google Maps. So let's right-click on the phone number and select Inspect Element. This lets us view the source code for our phone number. We can see it has been added to our website as a link, and that the link begins with TEL, a colon, and then the phone number. So we're going to use this first part of the URL to trigger a new GA4 event tag. Now let's head back to GTM. We're going to use the telephone link as a trigger to fire our tag. So we need to ensure information about the link click is available in GTM. To do this, let's navigate to Variables. And let's select Configure for the built-in variables. We need to ensure the click URL variable is enabled. And let's also enable click text. Now we need to navigate to Triggers. Let's create a new trigger. And let's name our trigger Phone Number Click. Now we select Trigger Configuration. And choose Just Links as the trigger type. If we save this trigger now, then it would fire our tag every time a link was clicked. But we just want to fire our tag when people click our phone number. So let's select Some Link Clicks. Using the drop-down on the left, let's select Click URL. Then let's select Starts With and enter TEL colon as the value. Now let's save our trigger. The next step is to create the tag that will send details about our phone call clicks to GA4. So let's navigate to Tags. Let's create a new tag. And let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Phone Number Click. Now let's select Tag Configuration and choose GA4 Event as the tag type. We need to select our GA4 configuration tag using the drop-down. As I mentioned previously, if you don't have a configuration tag yet, then I recommend watching my dedicated GTM tutorial where I cover how to get started. Now we need to name our event. I'm going to name the event Click @phone_number, but you can name your event anything you like. Just remember, whatever you enter here is what you'll see in your reports. Now let's select Event Parameters, and then Add Row. Parameters let you send extra information with events, so we're going to use them to capture the phone number from our website. This is useful if you have multiple phone numbers, so you can report on which phone numbers people are clicking. For the parameter name, let's enter phone_number. And for the value, let's enter 2 opening curly brackets, then click text, and let's select the variable. This will automatically capture the text that is linked on our website, so this will be our phone number. Now we need to apply the trigger to the tag. Let's select Triggering. And we need to choose the phone number click trigger we created earlier. Now we can save the tag. Have you followed the steps so far to set up GA4 phone call events? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you've run into any issues, feel free to post your questions too. Okay, now let's click Preview to test our tag and trigger. We enter the URL of our website. And click Connect. Our website loads. And let's navigate to the contact page. And let's click the phone number. Now let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We can see our phone number click tag has fired. Let's select the link click event on the left, and then our tag. Let's check that Values is selected on the top right corner. This lets us view the values of the variables that were sent to GA4. And we can see that the parameter we created has tracked the phone number from the link text. When you're happy, it's time to publish the changes to our website. So let's head back to GTM. And let's click Submit. And publish the changes to our website. Moving forward, we will be tracking clicks on our phone numbers in GA4. Now that we're tracking clicks on the phone number, we'll be able to start reporting on these clicks in GA4. I need to flag that you will be able to see your phone call clicks in the real-time report straight away, but you will need to wait 24 hours to see the clicks in your other reports. Okay, let's take a look at the reports. Let's head to Google Analytics. I've opened my demo property, and because I previously set up phone call click tracking and it's been over 24 hours, we will see the events in my reports. Let's navigate to Reports. Then Engagement. And Events. Looking at the table, we can see the Click Phone Number event. For more custom reporting, you can create an exploration report using the event name dimension. Before we wrap up, I want to show you two more things. I'm going to show you how to configure the event as a conversion and how to register the parameter as a custom dimension. Let's head back to Google Analytics to do this. Let's navigate to Admin. To configure conversions and register parameters, you will need editor or administrator permission in Google Analytics. If you don't have the correct level of permission, you'll either need to have your permission increased or get someone with the correct permission to set things up for you. Now let's select Events in the Property column. Then all we need to do is find our Click Phone Number event and enable it as a conversion using the Mark as Conversion switch on the right. Moving forward, clicks on our phone number will be counted as a conversion in our reports. If you also want to report on the value of the parameter that we configured in GTM, then you will need to set up a custom dimension. To do this, we navigate to Custom Definitions. And let's click Create Custom Dimensions. Let's name the dimension Phone Number. Leave Event as the scope. And enter Phone underscore Number as the event parameter. Then we click Save. Again, you will need to wait 24 hours before you'll be able to use the new custom dimension in your reports. I set this up previously, so let's take a look at where we can use the dimension. Let's navigate to Explore. And let's create a new exploration report. Let's click the plus sign to the right of dimensions. And let's search for and enable phone number. Now let's click Import. And let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for and enable Event Count. And let's click Import. Now let's add the dimension and metric to our report by double-clicking them. Since events can be collected without a phone number, we need to add a filter to our report. To do this, let's select Filters, and then Phone Number. For the match type, let's select Does Not Contain, and enter open bracket not set, close bracket as the value. Now let's click Apply. We're now reporting on our custom phone number dimension in GA4. Now you'll be able to report how many times people click your phone number to call you from your website. And there's even more to learn about GA4, so please take a moment to subscribe to this channel to get the latest tutorials on Google Analytics and GTM. Understanding your audience and how they use your website will take your business to the next level. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.